Some of the best practices in community policing are setting up initiatives and programs where we can engage the community to get them to see something and say something. I think that's beneficial. Most agencies now nationally are engaged in identifying their community partners and bringing them in to participate. We can engage the community and our community partners in a more positive way so that when there is a riot or some sort of disorder, we have them on speed dial and we can actually reach out to them and they can help us to kind of resolve issues in our community. Some of the current issues in criminal justice is trying to identify real talent in the police, in the courts, and also in criminal justice. I think college is key due to the professionalization of law enforcement, that individuals get an education prior to entering the police force or prior to entering the court system or prior to becoming correction officers. They're better communicators, they're better with conflict resolution, they're better writers. So we've seen that since there's been this, over the last 20 years, the requirement to have college in law enforcement, that we're getting better qualified candidates. I think law enforcement in training and also through education need to reinforce that police officers, specifically police officers of color, should maintain their culture and their identity. They'd be more sensitive to the issues that are happening in our community. They would be able to work collaboratively with the public because they remember what it was like, you know, to walk within the city as a Hispanic or an African American or an Asian American. And now they're engaged in the community and their identity is very important. Their culture is something that they need to maintain throughout their entire career.